Welcome to this machine tool video, Turning Between Centers. Turning between centers is a good way to learn the basic principles of lathe operations. It also ensures all of the turn features are concentric with the center holes. Parts can also be turned end for end in order to continue turning the entire length of the part without eccentricity. Before we begin, let's review all of the parts required. The drive plate is a small faceplate that attaches to the lathe spindle. It drives the lathe dog. A drive lug propels the lathe dog when the tail of the lathe dog doesn't reach the slot in the drive plate. The lathe dog clamps to the workpiece and transmits power from the drive plate to the workpiece. The headstock sleeve functions as a bushing between the lathe spindle and the live center. The live center is the center in the headstock spindle. It's called a live center because it rotates along with the spindle. It also supports the headstock end of the part. The last part in our setup is the tailstock center. It can be either a bearing center or a dead center. The dead center is a non-rotating center. Dead centers require a high-pressure lubricant. A bearing center is the preferred type of tailstock center whenever you're working with higher spindle speeds. The disadvantage of a bearing center is that they're not as accurate as a dead center. Now that we understand the necessary equipment, let's set up the work between centers. Before installing, you'll need to clean a number of different areas. Start with the headstock spindle and the sleeve. Use your hands to feel for chips or burrs after cleaning. These will cause the headstock center to run out. Then, clean the inside of the headstock sleeves and the live center. To verify this has been cleaned correctly, mount an indicator with the indicator needle against the point of the live center and check for runout. If the center runs out more than the allowable part tolerance, take the setup apart and re-clean all of the mating surfaces. Finally, you'll need to clean the tailstock spindle and the tailstock. Now you can start your setup. To set up a workpiece that has been previously center drilled, slip the lathe dog over the workpiece with the lathe dog tail toward the drive plate. Don't tighten the dog onto the workpiece just yet. If you're using a dead center in the tailstock, put anti-friction or high-pressure lubricant in the tailstock end of the workpiece. Next, place the workpiece between centers. Don't extend the tailstock spindle too far because the lack of rigidity causes chatter or vibrations. Slip the lathe dog tail into one of the slots in the drive plate. If you're using a drive lug, place the tail of the lathe dog in front of the lug. Tighten the dog and then adjust the tailstock spindle. Don't over-tighten the tailstock spindle. The lathe dog tail should move freely in the slot without any binding between it and the drive plate. Now, tighten the tailstock spindle lock. The heat of machining will expand the workpiece and cause the dead center to heat from friction. If it gets overheated, you may ruin the center and may even weld it into your workpiece. Now you can begin your project. As you work, you should periodically check the tailstock center adjustment. You've finished this video, Turning Between Centers.